2 Kings 22. I just want y'all to know that I have about 20 minutes to preach if we got out on time. So we'll see how it goes. I know I appreciate that spiritual folks who are here saying, don't worry about it. He did. You're right. He taught us that. The biggest hypocrite ever in that department. 2 Kings 22, beginning with verse 1. Josiah was 8 years old when he began to reign. We'll talk about that just briefly, shortly. He reigned 31 years in Jerusalem. His mother's name was Jedidah, the daughter of Adaiah of Bosra. And he did that which was right in the sight of the Lord and walked in all the way of David his father and turned not aside to the right hand or to the left. Lord, may that be true then. And it came to pass in the 18th year of King Josiah that the king sent Shaphan, the son of Azaliah, the son of Mesulam. If y'all want to do a better job of pronouncing these, I'll let you. The scribe to the house of the Lord, saying, go up to Hilkiah, the high priest, that he may sum the silver which is brought into the house of the Lord, which the keepers of the door have gathered of the people, and let them deliver it under the hand of the doers of the work. That have the oversight of the house of the Lord, and let them give it to the doers of the work, which is in the house of the Lord, to repair the breaches of the house, and the carpenters and builders and masons, and to buy timber and hewn stone to repair the house. I think some of that's about to go in here, isn't it? Howbeit, there was no reckoning made with them of the money that was delivered into their hand, because they dealt faithfully. Such honesty, they didn't need any accounting. Hilkiah, the high priest, said in the station and scribe, I found the book of the law. And the Lord, they did all their innovations. They found the book of the law. Hilkiah gave the book to Shaphan, and he read it. And Shaphan, the scribe, came to the king and brought the king word again and said, thy servants have gathered the money that was found in the house and delivered it, and at the hand of them that do the work, they have the oversight of the house of the Lord. And Shaphan the scribe showed the king, saying, Hilkiah the priest hath delivered me a book. And Shaphan read it before the king, and it came to pass when the king heard the words of the book of the law, he tore his clothes in grief. But the words hadn't been spoken for a while. And the king commanded Hilkiah the priest, and Hakim the son of Shaphan, and Akbor the son of Micaiah, the Shaphan, the scribe, and Asahiah, the servant of the king, saying, go, ye, inquire of the Lord for me, and for the people, and for all Judah, concerning the words of this book of the same. For great is the wrath of the Lord that is kindled against us, because our fathers have not hearkened unto the words of this book, to do according to the words of this book. This is what God said in verse 18, that the king of Judah, which sent you to the point of the Lord, God said to him, and he 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 sent those who would assist him and help him. He said, go, do what God has called you to do. Take this book and find out what God is telling us through these things. Josiah tore his clothes. It was a sign that in that day of greatest grief, the diagnosis was made, and he had great regret for their failures of the past. And he said, pastors, go do your work. The word of God, back to America. If we want to rebuild America, what do we got to do? What are our children taught about the founders of America? Thomas Jefferson, for example. They learn he wrote the Declaration of Independence and that he owned slaves. Is that what they learned? I'm afraid so. The kind of teaching going on in America has led to Charles to tear down his statue among many others. They ignore the fact of how truth works and how truth worked in this country. Jefferson was a man of the world being confronted and contradicted by the Word of God. He was being confronted by the message of truth. He was a man moved and influenced by the morality of the root of righteousness that had come to America along with those trying to make money, along with sinners, along with slaveholders. He was a man moved and influenced by the morality of the root of righteousness that had come along with all the sinners. The children seldom or never hear what Jefferson wrote in notes to the state of he's been hearing about the attributes of God. He said, I tremble for our country. Jefferson wrote about the contest between the master and the slave. And this is a quote from him. The Almighty has no attribute which can take side with us in such a contest. There is no attribute of God that will side with me as a slave owner, is what he was saying. He trembled for his country because of slavery. How many times are our children taught that in school? I think all they're taught is he wrote the Declaration of Independence and he held slaves. Not the power of the gospel in his life. The influence of truth in his life. The influence of truth in America. It wasn't a place where sinners didn't exist. It was a place where the gospel came. It's going to change lives. It's Brother Nate's life was changed by the gospel. Our children most likely never hear that when our nation first expanded into the Northwest Territory, that land was ceded to the federal government from Virginia. And on a motion made by Thomas Jefferson, that slavery in that land be eternally forbidden. Eternally forbidden. That's the word he used. We'll give the federal government this land if slavery is eternally forbidden. Because of the justice of God. And Jefferson had inherited old sinful ways that were being exposed by the preaching of the attributes of a holy and just God. What are we missing? What are we missing? Ways he once embraced, he regretted. He thought again. That's what the gospel does. That's what preaching has to be God do. That is the miracle, the truth of God that took root in the founding of this great country. That's why we love America, not because of the sins of the past, but because of the goodness that the gospel has created in America. The wonder of America isn't that we weren't sinners. The wonder of America was the acknowledgement of the God of the Bible and the truth of God, influencing this nation and written into our family. Satan wants to destroy it. And if we don't have counteracting truth from the pulpits of America, Satan wins. He wins. That's what we're all about. That's what we're here for. That's what this denomination is about. That's what you're supporting. That's what you're loving. That's why you're still here in spite of this stuff. Only possible in truth is present and growing in the church. What about this King Josiah? Just as the New Testament has those gospel accounts, you have the same account, but you have different information, you have different angles and different messages that are being taught. The same is true in Chronicles, 1st and 2nd Kings, and 1st and 2nd Chronicles. Josiah was 16. Remember, he was 8 when he started to rule. But in 2 Chronicles 34:3, we find out he was 16. He began to seek after God. He was 8 when he began to rule. I know Mama probably had to be involved in others to help in that process. But when he was 16, he began to seek after God. And then when he was 20, the Bible tells us there, he began to purge Judah and Jerusalem. You don't have to be old to make a difference. That's the message we've got to get out in the Bethel message. That you don't have to be old to make a difference. You don't have to be old. God, through Jeremiah the prophet, bragged on Josiah in Jeremiah 22, verses 11 through 17. I won't get into all of that. But Jeremiah bragged on Josiah. What a just king. He did the right thing. He did it in the context of complaining about another one later. That is funny. There's a lot to do with it. And it's got to be done. The special kind of instrument dedicated to the world for the history of the I don't know if you zoomed last Sunday in the Hill Country. I don't know if any of you were there. That's the problem. I don't know who's listening and who's not, sometimes. Or who's listening online. Y'all, we had 3 in attendance last Sunday. My 4-wheel Jeep got us there, and then one brave soul on a sheet of ice made it to church. So I had 3, Cindy, me, and one other. I had an attorney who's been coming to our church since we're open. And he will be substituting for me in Sunday school coming up when I'm gone again. He was there. Drove his car halfway up our drive until it slid into the grass, and he got out and walked the rest of the way. But people were listening to me preach, so I don't know who's heard it and who hasn't. But I want to steal from that a little bit. I preached from the watchman. And the role of the watchman. A watchman must be vigilant. He can't be distracted. He must be dedicated to the task of watching. He is called to be dedicated to the Word as an occupation so that all can be aided in all their work and all their responsibilities. This is such a noble calling. And I would challenge all young people and old people alike to seek the will of God as far as their calling, so that all can be aided in all of their work and all of their responsibilities. It's very simple. In Ezekiel 3, verse 17, it is articulated, Son of man, I've made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word at my mouth and give them warning from me. That's what God tells me to do. All of us need to hear that God has called men, especially a full-time vocation, to listen to the Word of God and then the people. When those who are supposed to serve the Word fail, then the Word perishes from the land. 2 Kings 22:8, the book of the law had been lost in the house of the Lord. What did the king order along with the officer of his court and the secretary and all the support he needed, the pastor, the priest, who sent him on a mission to go and inquire the Lord for me and for the people and for all Judah concerning the words of this book? Go do your job. Go do your calling. Just follow the need. For great is the wrath of the Lord that is kindled against us because our fathers had not hearkened unto the words of this book. There was a king, there were families, there were workers, and the king understood it. We need help and we need support in understanding these words. Jesus said in John 5:39, search the scriptures. They are they which speak of me. They are they which speak of me. You want to walk with Jesus? You want to talk with Jesus? Spend time with the Lord. The local pastor is a watchman of the word. Not a watchman of the carpet, not a watchman of the computer, the camera, the Zoom, the overflowing toilets. Hopefully you don't have that. Frozen pipes. keep the watchman focused on the Lord's God. And they were such understanding. And God is there. In order to help have it available to all, the watchman is set free to pursue the Word. That role is so vital in every church, in every denomination. Think of a company that has a great product, but instead of product development, all the company's energy is going to promotion.